Hi everyone, welcome. In this exercise, we wanted to compare precipitation measurements from rain gauge with precipitation estimate from satellite. Satellites provide aerial estimates of precipitation, while rain gauge provide point measurements. Therefore, one way of comparing rain gauge data with satellite estimate is to extract data from the satellite estimates of the pixel where the rain gauge is located, and compare this with the rain gauge measurement. To do this, we need to know the location of the rain gauge station and extract the precipitation estimate from the satellite data. Make sure you have the required data. If you download the datacheck.zip file from the course platform, you must have the following folders and files. This Jupyter Notebook, a folder PACT which contains the pmonthly.nc file, folder POBS, which contains 6 CSV files of rain gauge measurement. This script extracts satellite precipitation measurement from the monthly precipitation SCDF file for the locations of rain gauge stations, compute some statistics between the satellite estimate, the rain gauge observation, and plot bar charts and scatter plots of the data. We need to import the required packages, which are listed here. And the next cell contains some functions which we will use for this exercise. The first function calculates some statistics between the observed and estimated values, including the Nash-Sutcliffe efficiency criteria, root mean square error, and coefficient of determination. The second function computes regression line between the observed estimate values and functions to plot bar chart and scatter plots of the data. The name of the gauging stations and their locations is given here in the form of Python dictionary, which includes the name and the latitude and longitude of the stations. We can access the station name and the latitude longitude by mentioning the names and which data we want to access. And then we need to read the monthly data, which is the pmonthly.netcdf file. So please make sure that you have the right path according to where you saved your data. And we use XRA to open and read the data set. And we can inspect the precipitation data set, which has latitude and longitude as indicated here, and the time step 84 months, which starts from January 2009 up to December 2015. We can visualize the data as this cube, the precipitation data, where each column represents the monthly data and the X and Y coordinates are given by the latitude and longitude. We can plot one of the monthly data, and also on top of that, we can plot the location of the gauging stations to observe where the gauging stations are located within the basin. Here we can see the monthly precipitation for July 2009 and the locations of the 6 gauging stations within the Awash River Basin. We can extract from the NetCDF file for each location the time series of monthly precipitation values. So for example, if we do that for a station Addis Ababa OBS and the longitude latitude, we can access it from the dictionary given above. And if we say P, the data set, select for latitude given by lat, longitude given by long, and we use the nearest method. And if we plot that time series, we will see the monthly precipitation values for the station. We can convert this time series into data frame and inspect the data frame. Here we can see that this data frame has index column of time and three columns, latitude, longitude, and precipitation, the monthly precipitation values. We don't want the latitude and longitude information as columns here, so we can drop those columns, and we want to rename this precipitation column into the name of the gauging station. We can do that by this part of the script, and we can observe the data frame again. So you can see that now we have in the data frame only one column, and the column name is the station name, and WAPOR is appended to indicate that it's from WAPOR data. So we can do the same for all the six stations by combining the above script. And if we run that, we expect a data frame which contains the six monthly rainfall values for the six ringed stations. Python is still busy. Okay, now it's finished, so we can inspect the data frame. As you can expect, this data frame has six columns of for the six ringed stations. So now we have the precipitation estimate from satellite data in a data frame. So the next step is to read the observed values from these files, the files given, to have the observed values as a data frame. And we do that by running this script. If we run that and inspect the observed data frame, we get here with time index column and six stations, where none indicates the missing values, and where we have value, we see the values. So now we have the observed of the gauge data in one data frame and the precipitation estimate from satellite in another data frame. So what we can do, we can combine for each station the observed value and the satellite estimate from the two data sets and plot those data. And we do that by running this script. The script, first we take the first two stations. Here we do for the first two stations, and the remaining four stations, you will do it for your exercise, as an exercise. So if we run this, we get the plots, the bar chart, and the scatter plots for each station. As you can see, the blue bar indicates the data from WAPOR, the satellite estimate, and the red bar indicates the observations. So we can see how well the satellite estimate agree with the ringage observation for each station. This is all about comparing satellite estimates with ringage observation. I hope you will do the same for the remaining four stations. And if you have questions, please post them in the discussion forum, and one of you please may help you out. Thank you very much, and hope to